गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन. टुडे आई विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट ओवरव्यू ऑफ कंबाइंड स्ट्रेस रिसर्च इन लेग्यूम क्रॉप्स अराउंड द वर्ल्ड एंड दिस इज पार्ट टू विच आई विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट. सो अर्लियर इन द पार्ट वन आई हैव shown which major stress combinations actually affect legume crops, and in this part we will see like in detail how the biomass and yield productivity is affected in different stress combination for different legume crops. So just to introduce again that why we are choosing to talk about legumes. So very briefly, I will talk about why we are focusing on legumes. So we know that consumption, it is used for consumption, human consumption, and as a source of protein and dietary fibers, carbohydrate and mineral, and it has capacity to fix atmospheric nitrogen. It is used for the diversification of crops in various agrosystems, and it represents the Leguminosae family represents the third largest family of flowering plants, which comprises of around 800 genera and 20,000 species. So, Food and Agricultural Organization of the UN body has declared 2016 as the International Year of Pulses, just to re-emphasize and put legumes on a global platform. And why it is so important, the consumption of legume is so important. So we can see here that a 100 gram serving can provide with many vital protein and minerals such as fiber, folate and manganese. And legumes include crops such as black beans, kidney beans, red lentils, yellow split pea, chickpea and soybean are two major crops. Again, and mung bean, green beans and peas. So when we look at the production, world legume production, so India is the largest producer for chickpea and pigeon pea, followed by Australia and Myanmar. And if we look at the losses which occur because of various kind of stress which the plants encounter in the environment, so it can estimate between 23 to 87%, which can be caused by weeds only, and various viral diseases can be caused in bean and pigeon pea, which can lead to severe losses of crops. So again, just to re-emphasize the fact that a host plant comprises of many abiotic and biotic factor which comes in the environment, and any one factor can cause a severe effect in the health of the plant. So a healthy plant is a result of its surrounding, and any imbalance in one of these factors will result in unhealthy plant growth. So there's a need to understand this relationship and its various environmental factors. So to summarize broadly, combined stress can be categorized into three broad categories, which is abiotic. Under this category, we have found so far 11 combinations comprising around 25 plus articles. The second category being the abiotic-biotic category, in which we have come across 22 stress combination with 50 plus articles which affect the legume crops. And the third category being the biotic-biotic stress combination, which we have encountered 9 stress, different type of stress combination with over 80 articles. And various crops like soybean, chickpea, alfalfa, lentil, peanut, cowpea have been so far known to get affected by these various stress combination. So in this current talk, I will show you the data from the various sources which we have collected so far, and to compare the data at a same level, we have taken these many parameters and compared the percentage change with respect to control in different legume species. So these are the various type of parameters which we have taken into consideration, like leaf number, leaf area, leaf elongation rate, yield, plant height, grain yield, etc. So what we have done is we have taken the data from various sources related parameter. Then we have done a percentage change calculation with respect to the control values and compared with each other. So in my slides ahead, I will show you six different legume crops. So first being the chickpea, which is majorly getting affected by drought and heat, salinity and ozone, heavy metal and nematode and fungus stress. Second being the alfalfa, which is again an important forage crop. And in this crop, I will show an effect of flooding and insect, fungus insect. Nematode and oomycete, nematode and fungus. Similarly for pea, soybean, cowpea and bean, these stress combinations have been reported so far. So I will first start with chickpea. So in this first category being abiotic, we see that parameters like seed number, shoot weight and plant height get affected under combined stress and drought and heat and salinity and ozone cause severe detrimental effect under combined stress condition compared to individual stresses. And in this study, cultivars such as ICC 4567 and CSG 8890 has been used in these studies. In the next category for chickpea, which is abiotic, the stress combination here shows effect of heavy metal, which is nickel, and nematode, which is Melodogyne javanica. And here it is clearly shown that the yield of chickpea is severely reduced under combined stress compared to the individual stress. The third category of biotic interaction in chickpea has shown that fungus and nematode is the major combination which is affecting its growth and yield. So pathogens like Pratelenchus thorni, Fusarium oxysporum, and Melodogyne javanica, Rhizoctonia batticola, and Macrophomina fasciolina, they all can affect in the environment and affect singly, individually, or together in a combined stress condition to cause severe loss in the parameters such as growth parameters and in parameters such as root weight, yield, plant height, shoot weight, and number of pods. So these studies have been conducted in various chickpea cultivars such as CPS1, Shendi, JG62, Enagiri, and Avrodi. So looking at this data here, we can clearly say that combined nematode and fungus stress is more deleterious compared to individual stress of fungus or nematode. So moving to the second crop, which is alfalfa. This graph here shows effect of abiotic-biotic stress combination, which is insect and flood. So the insect species here is Emposa febi. And we can see that the root dry weight here is highly reduced under combined stress condition compared to the individual stress. So clearly it is more deleterious than the individual stress. So the next category for this alfalfa is biotic-biotic stress category. So here also we see that combined oomycete and nematode, which is red in color, and nematode and fungus, which is black in color, it is more deleterious. However, fungus and insect does not have that much combined effect because it is almost similar to the insect value here. So we can see here that oomycete and nematode and fungus are clearly two major stress combination which are affecting the growth of alfalfa severely. The third crop being is pea, and here effect of drought and salt has been shown on leaf area. So we clearly see that the under combined stress condition, the leaf area is severely reduced compared to the individual stress. Thus, it is more deleterious to the plant. Next category for P is biotic-biotic stress combination. So stress combination like virus, nematode, fungus, oomycete, and virus and fungus can affect these plant, and pathogen species such as P. mosaic virus and Melidogyne incognita, Rhizoctonia solanae, Aphenomyces, and again Rhizoctonia solanae can affect together to cause severe growth defect in the pea plant. So here biomass, dry weight and root length are severely reduced under combined stress condition compared to the individual stress. Next crop being the soybean, which is again a very important legume crop. And for this crop, first we will see the abiotic-abiotic stress combination. So heavy metal and UV, cold and light, and ozone and UV have been reported to affect the growth of soybean plants. So when you see here the the growth parameters such as root length, plant height, biomass, dry weight, and yield values are severely reduced under combined stress compared to the individual stress. So again, we can see that combined ozone, UV, cold, low light, and heavy metal and UV are more deleterious compared to individual stress. In the abiotic category for soybean, drought and weed appear to be the major stress combination which affected the plant growth. So we see that for this category, we see that drought and quackgrass showed more reduction in yield compared to the individual stress. However, for Alternanthera, Tenella, Tridex, Procumbens, and Digitaria cilaris did not show an additive effect here. In the panel C, D, and E did not show an additive effect. So we can say that quackgrass and common cocklebur affect the soybean more compared to the other wheat species. Moving to the biotic-biotic category, we see that pathogens like nematode and virus, fungus and insect and fungus and nematode and oomycete are known to affect soybean plant. And we see here that combined stress is more deleterious compared to the individual stress. And various pathogen species like Melodogyne incognita, soybean mosaic virus, Macrofomina, Phacelina, Rhizoctonia solanae, Phytophthora megasperma can affect soybean crops along with other pathogens. Next crop is the cowpea, wherein the drought and virus have been known to reduce the biomass of the cowpea plants more drastically compared to the individual stress. So here the interaction is shown between drought and cowpea severe mosaic virus, which is more deleterious in combination with drought compared to the individual stress. The next category is biotic-biotic stress for cowpea. So here again, the nematode fungus was the major combination which affected the cowpea growth and yield. And we see here that combined stress is more deleterious compared to the individual stress. And pathogens such as Heterodera kijani, Fusarium solanae, Fusarium oxysporum, Melitogyne javanica can affect the growth of cowpea severely compared to the compare when they affect individually. So the last crop being it is bean. So here are few biotic-biotic stress combination which have been reported so far for the bean plant. So, like nematode and fungus, bacteria and oomycete and fungus, and fungus. So, except bacteria and oomycete, we see that combined stress is more deleterious compared to the individual stress. And pathogens such as Melitogyne incognita, Macrofomina faciolina, Uromyces faciolus, Dysactonia bataticola, Pythium griseola can affect individually or in combination the bean plant and can drastically reduce the growth and yield of the plant. So to summarize, overall these studies, they highlight the investigations done in various possibilities of combined stress area and showing the effect of biomass or yield parameters of plants. So basically we have observed that the combined stress negatively affect the biomass and yield parameters of all these legume plants. So in future, it is important to identify these major stress combination and assess the impact of various stress combination on these legume plants, which can lead to development of stress-tolerant resistant cultivars by molecular biology tool. And also, it is very important to safeguard the nitrogen fixation activity of green legumes and find the suitable approach to achieve the best improvements. So these are the references. If somebody wants to go back to the articles, thank you.